Hi, I'm Melissa, and today I wanted to show you how to make treacle tart. So, if you haven't heard of it before, it's a classic British dessert. You may have heard them mention it in Harry Potter, and I had never really heard of it besides Harry Potter until I watched the Great British Baking Show. So, they made it on the show, so I'm gonna make it now for you guys, and I am using Mary Berry's recipe. This is super quick, super easy, minimal ingredients. It's actually gonna use, the base of the tart is sandwich bread. So if you have bread lying around that you're not using, you could use that. The only thing that might not be in your pantry, or probably won't be in your pantry, is golden syrup. This is the other main ingredient for the tart. You should be able to find it in the international section of your grocery store. Otherwise, you can order it on Amazon. The one I have is Lyle's Golden Syrup. It comes in like a little like paint can. It's kind of cute. I think it also comes in like squeeze bottles too. So the first thing that we're gonna start with is the crust. In my bowl, I have 1 2/3 cup of flour, and I added 10 tablespoons of butter, and I just smushed it around with my hands until the butter was completely incorporated into the flour. So now it's this crumbly, sticky, it's not quite dough, but it's crumbly and sticky. If you take your hand and like squish it, it should stick together. So it's almost into a dough. Now we just need to add cold water. So we're gonna do about 3 tablespoons of cold water. That was just my oven preheating. So we're gonna put the cold water in, and now it should be able to stick together into a dough. So just get in there with your hands. Okay, so my crust dough is ready. Now it just needs to chill in the fridge for 20 minutes, a half hour or so. So it's gonna fridge while we start making the filling. This is just a basic short crust pastry. So if you wanted to be lazy, you could just buy a couple of pie crusts from the store. It's the same thing, pretty much. So I'm just gonna take some saran wrap and wrap this crust up. And we're gonna stick it in the fridge. All right, next up is the filling. So all the filling is one whole can of this golden syrup, which is 454 grams. I don't know how many ounces it is. And I took 2 medium-sized lemons and I zested the entire thing, so I have all the zest from both lemons. And I juiced both of them, so I have lemon zest, juice, golden syrup, and we're going to use 1/2 loaf of sandwich bread. So the only other prep we need to do for this is we have to cut the crusts off the sandwich bread, and then I'm gonna use my food processor and I'm gonna stick the sandwich bread in there and like blitz it until it's in like breadcrumbs. Okay, so I did 9 slices of bread. It's a little over 1/2 loaf. You might want to do more or less depending on how thick you want the filling. This is how much I usually do, and it's okay. And also, the bread, you might want it to be a little bit on the stale side because then it's easier for it to soak in the syrup for the filling. So the next part, we have our breadcrumbs and we have our golden syrup and our lemon zest and juice. So the next thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go over to the oven, and I have a big skillet. It doesn't have to be this big, just you need like a non-stick skillet on medium heat, and you're gonna throw in the breadcrumbs, the corn syrup, the golden syrup, and the lemon juice and the lemon zest and cook it a little bit to incorporate the filling, to make the filling. Okay, so while the filling is heating up on the stove, keep an eye on it because you don't want it to get to a boil. You just want to heat it up until the golden syrup starts to get liquidy. Its regular consistency is, you know, like a corn syrup type thing. Once it heats up, it'll get a little bit thinner. So it shouldn't take that long on the stove, but in the meantime, we're gonna roll out our crust and put it into our tin. So since it's a tart, you usually want to use a tart tin. I don't have one, so I'm just going to use a pie dish. So you want probably an 8-inch tart tin if you have one, and if you don't, you can just use a pie dish like I'm using. So this is gonna be enough for us to roll out. Here, I'm gonna cut it in half right now. For us to roll out the bottom, and then we're making a lattice top. So I'm just gonna roll this out and put it into my dish. So I put my crust into the pie dish, and now I'm just gonna trim the edges and I'm gonna cut the pieces for the lattice. And this part you have to be a little bit quick because the filling is warm and you wanna get it into here, put the lattice on top, egg wash it, and then put it in the oven. So you wanna preheat your oven to 400 degrees while you're doing this. Alright, I have the long strips for the lattice. Now I'm gonna pour the filling into my crust. Okay, so I put it into the pie crust, so this is what it looks like. And now I'm gonna make the lattice crust. If you want to learn how to make the lattice crust, because that's a little more involved, and I'm gonna do some close-ups, check out my lattice crust technique video. I'm gonna link it to this video, and then it's gonna get egg washed and thrown into the oven, and you'll see it when it's all done. Okay, so the treacle tart cooked for, like I said, 400 degrees for 10 minutes, and then decreased it to 350, and it stayed in for another 25 minutes. I did forget to say, right before you put in the oven, you wanna put an egg wash on it. So just beat one egg, you put a little bit of water in it, and brush the top. Just try not to get any egg wash on the filling, just try to get it on the lattice top, on the crust. So now it's all cooked, it's nice and golden. And I'm going to cut a slice. I don't have a pie cutter, all I have is this knife. Cute little slice of treacle tart. And the filling is going, you want to let it cool for like 10-15 minutes after you take it out of the oven. I do actually like eating this cool, I don't like eating it warm. And you need to let it cool because the filling needs to set. If you try and cut it while it's still hot, it'll mush out. But this is relatively set, see how it's not really moving. It's still pretty warm, but it's really good. It's really super lemony, and the bread just gives it like, you don't even know it's bread, the filling, it's just like mushy. So it's just like this yummy, mushy, lemony flavor. So super yummy, super quick, super easy. I hope you make it. Make sure to check out some other videos I have and subscribe to my channel if you want to see more. Have a great day.